I'm Don Robertson, and I'm going to show you a tabla piece. It's called Rayla, and it's in 16 beats. And so it's divided into four lines or four sections, and I'll show you them one by one here, so the all four. So starting with the first goes like this. All right, so these tabla compositions have bold groups in them, and these are common groups that are used in all the different compositions. So you learn the actual group, and then you can play different compositions. So it's like bold groups are like Dagena or Titi Kata or Teri Tite, Giri Naga. So here's the first line. Played over and over. Okay, so the second line, the first two beats of the second line are the same as the first two beats of the first line. But then we have dinagerinaka. Gerinaka is repeated again. So there's a kind of a poetic rhythm to this, having a similarity to perhaps a poem or a song, or even in classical music, when you have a melody that's played twice, but the ending is a little different, and you might be repeating some of the melodic elements from the first part in the second. Well, same thing going on here. I mean, we Gerinaga, ba te te, Gerinaga, Gerinaga, te te kita, ba te te, Gerinaga, jina, Gerinaga. So that one sound combination is played a number of times there. So together, the two lines. Again. Okay, again. Over and over. Okay. Now there's two more lines to go. Third line. Introduce a new vowel combination. It's called dere dere. Dere dere, okay? So we play that twice. So it's beat 9 and 10, or the first two beats of the line. Dere 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 dere. Then, Giri Naga, our friend, and then Dina Naga, okay? Sometimes pronounce it. Some people say, Naga or Taga. Alright. So Diddy 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 Naka Diddy Naka. Diddy 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 Naka Diddy Naka. For the fourth line, we repeat to the second line. So the whole composition. Alright, 16 beats. Okay, now that is the composition, but in Indian music, in the drumming, if you take this composition, and it's in a Raylan, Kaida, and Chalan, some of these types of forms, those are the three basic types that we're talking about here. And then there's offshoots and so forth, and then there's different schools of playing. We won't get into all that. However, you take that composition, and what you want to do is you want to play that, and then you want to create variations. And so if you listen to Beethoven and Mozart, and you'll find that these composers compose theme and variations. That would be the name. So they say this is a theme and variations, and they write it out. And so you'd have your theme, and then you'd have a set of variations on that theme. So so maybe the theme is da 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 da. da 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 da. You get the idea. So same thing goes on here. So before you can, so you present your theme and then you present the variations. But in our drumming here, what we have is a system called Bari and Kali. And what that's all about is you, when you play that, what I just showed you, the 16-beat composition, you always repeat it again. And so it's 32 beats all together. The second time you play it, the first part of that, all these sounds that are made on your left-hand drum, the baya, those sounds, they become this sound. So in other words, this is open baya. And this is closed. So if you take the first line and close it, it's so I'll show you the difference. All right. So this is the second part. It's called the Kali. The first part's the Bari. So when you talk about Kali, you're talking about close. Just at the first half. It could be a little less than half, a little more, or whatever. But it comes back in the second half to the body, the open. So, Kali. That's two lines. First two lines, now play close, and now it comes back to do the second part open. Alright, so the whole thing. Okay, so the whole 32 beats is like this. You start listening to tabla as a appreciation, and that's always where I am aiming at in my work with education. What I am doing is introducing to the students, today's students, this amazing North Indian classical music as an appreciation. So you'll benefit from understanding and getting what this music's all about and its benefits. And rhythmically, which is what we would talk about here with drums, in addition to the ideas I'm just showing you with just the form itself, these things can be applied, the form part can be applied to any kind of melodies. So it's not just rhythmic, but the rhythmic part, the tabla, we don't just use 16 cycles. We have 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. When I first wrote my tabla book in 1968, I went to the New York Public Library and found some very old books where they talked about compositions that were played in cycles of 100 beats. So it became at some point in the history of North Indian classical music, a very advanced form of memorization and rhythmic activity and appreciation. And so the audiences in India can appreciate this music. And that's what I'm trying to introduce, because frankly, try to learn these drums that's a whole lifetime's endeavor in itself. And I'm still working at it. I'm not a professional tabla player. But I practice these just 15 minutes a day or 20, or it just depends. And I've been doing it for a long, long time, 50 years, something like that. So I started in 67, fall of 67. So All right, so you play that theme. You play it much faster than that, because at the faster speed, you just can understand things better, appreciate it. And that's why sometimes even my great teachers that I've studied with, they try to show me things at slow speed, and I do this too, and I can't remember something. I think, what goes there? I know this, but I can't get it. And then I play it really fast, and just there it is. Now, the other thing is with the kali and the body, when you hear these closed parts, it always aligns you with that part of the 16-beat cycle. So all kinds of compositions use that closed and open system in order to identify where you are in the cycle. So then you start adding the variation. So very often, you can almost call it a normative thing. For your first variation, is just take the first line and play it three times, and then play the last line. Or in the case of a two-line, because you can have a two-line composition instead of four, and actually more common, you would play the first line three times and the second one once. So. The next variation, now explain these variations a little bit. When you study tabla with a teacher, what the teacher will do is give you a set of variations to learn when you're learning tabla and you're learning how to make variations. You don't know how to make them. So you have to have examples. That's the same in any music. That's why when you learn Western classical music, well, sometimes I just say classical music, that's usually what I'm referring to. That was the tradition I was brought up in and I understood all my life. In that tradition, it's the same thing. You can't figure out how to write a symphony from a book. I mean, you need to listen and study the scores and get the examples. So the teacher in North Indian classical music will give you, and this is the same in the melodic instruments too, when you're doing that same sort of thing, where you're doing these variations called B-star. So what you do is you get these variations that I'll show you, that one with the 3+1 that I just showed you, and then they'll start giving you more, and you'll sit there and watch your teacher. Sometimes they're just figuring them out as they go along what to give you next. It's not like they have a whole set all memorized, because to get from being given a set of variations to learn, and then what they call a tihai, which comes at the end, to the point where you can play professionally is a very, 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 very long way. And when you get to that point, I would say, I would have to imagine, because I'm not at that point, but I'm enough along to know what I'm talking about here. You just have this creative situation going on where you can just come up with these variations. I have one teacher, Subhajyoti, who's very mathematically inclined, and when I learn from him, I can tell how he's explaining to me how this is, well, this, I use this three times and this two, and that adds up to this, and he's just doing that real quickly in his mind, I believe. At any rate, when you start out, you just memorize these sets of variations, and then you start playing them, and when you can play them, and then you play enough different kaitas or enough different relas that pretty soon you get a real concept of making variations, and then you follow that. You might be just in the middle of playing a set of variations and you think, ah, I'll play this one now. And another thing about the variations is what you do is you build on something that's in the original theme. So for example, I just played the first line over three times and then the second line. So normally what you do when you've done that is you'd want to build on that first line. So you could take, let's say, the second two beats, beats three and four, second set of two beats, and repeat it twice. So, and then repeat, okay, and there's two lines. So you're building on the Geri Nagateru Kita. Now, you could go and do more and more variations, and you could Da-Tita Geri Nagateru Kita, Geri Nagateru Kita, Geri Nagateru Kita, like I did, but maybe be Geri Nagateru Kita, Geri Nagateru Kita, Teru Kita, Geri Nagateru Kita. You know, you could just do it different ways. Geri Nagateru Kita, Geri Nagateru Kita, Geri Nagateru Kita. That could be one. And you could do that variation and then do the last two lines. So you could do Geri Nagateru Kita, Geri Nagateru Kita, Da-Tita Geri Nagateru Kita, then Da-Tita Geri Nagateru Kita, Da-Tita Geri Nagateru Kita, add the two lines on the end. So I'm showing you how you can build on that first line. So you want to, you after you do that, then you probably want to build on, let's say, the deri-deris. So, so what you have there is you've created a variation where you have line three twice and then line three again and then line four, or that's not what I did. I did line three twice and then line one and then line four, or line two, that's the same. Okay? And then you could do another variation. And then. Or. So now when you're done with all your variations, any number of variations, I mean, that's up to you. I've seen some really great drummers that can, some very common kaitas that say they were reilos that they played for a long time. They can just play variations. They just smile away and play these things as if it was just, they were just there and they're just happening. So and there's all these different ways you can. You always end with a T high, and the T high in North Indian classical music is it's either a phrase that's repeated three times, and in Tintal that's just like 11 beat phrase. I'd say there's different ways of doing this stuff, but you'd say you take 11 and 11, and what happens is you repeat the phrase, and then the very last note is the downbeat of the next cycle. So when you preach something three times, you go, it's like going, one, two, three, go! One, two, three, go! One, two, three, and then go lands on the beginning of the cycle. So that's crazy cool. It's really, really, really good. And the musicians do that, the instrumentalists, the singers, everybody does that. That's a way of ending a structure. It could just be a solo, a random solo, and at the end you just gotta end it, and then you're right on the downbeat and everybody's all in sync. The other type of T-high could start out with a phrase and then another phrase, and that second phrase repeats itself three times. So it could be something, I don't know if this could be 16 beats, just top of my head.
And
then it could be that type of phrase repeated three times. And, or it could be, yeah, all right, so you get the idea. So we can use this one, which is very common, 11 beat one. Da-ti-ti-geri-naka-geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, da-ti-ti-geri-naka-geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, da-ti-ti-geri-naka-geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da, geri-naka-teri-ki-ta-da. Now notice the second one is offbeat because see the first one, see they're 11, so I'm doing half, I'm doing 11 half beats. So da tita kita taka tita kata gudi, tita kata gudi gina da, tita kata gudi gina da. Da tita kita taka tita kata gudi gina da, tita kata gudi gina da, tita kata gudi gina da. Ah, see, okay? That was a theme and then a T high.